In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Greetings, God's good people, and welcome. It is a new day, it is a new week, and it is yet another season of the church's year. Today is Monday, the 24th of May 2021. We are in the 8th week in Ordinary Time, Church Year B. The church celebrates today the memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Help of Christians. You are listening to Catholic Meditation, and at the anchor for presentation, I am your servant, Father Blessed Ambang Njume. Good morning, and thanks for joining us. Let us pray. Lord our God, who chose the mother of your beloved Son to be the mother and help of Christians, grant that we may live under her protection and that your church may enjoy unbroken peace. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. We, however, use the readings for the occurring weekday. The first reading is taken from the book of Sirach, chapter 17, verses 24 to 29. The responsorial psalm is taken from Psalm 32, and the response to the psalm is, Rejoice in the Lord, exalt you just. The gospel is taken from St. Mark, chapter 10, verses 17 to 27. I read from the gospel. At that time, Jesus was setting out on his journey. A man ran up and knelt before him and asked him, Good teacher, what must I do to inherit eternal life? And Jesus said to him, Why do you call me good? No one is good but God alone. You know the commandments. Do not kill. Do not commit adultery. Do not steal. Do not bear false witness. Do not defraud. Honor your father and mother. And he said to him, Teacher, all this I have observed from my youth. And Jesus, looking up upon him, loved him, and said to him, You lack one thing. Go, sell what you have, and give to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven, and come follow me. At that saying, his countenance fell, and he went away sorrowful, for he had great possessions. And Jesus looked around and said to his disciples, How hard it will be for those who have riches to enter the kingdom of God. And the disciples were amazed at his words. But Jesus said to them again, Children, how hard it is for those who trust in riches to enter the kingdom of God. It is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to enter the kingdom of God. And they were exceedingly astonished and said to him, Then who can be saved? Jesus looked at them and said, With men it is impossible, but not with God, for all things are possible with God. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
The theme for today's meditation is, let nothing or no one stand between you and your heaven. Let nothing or no one stand between you and your heaven. Beloved of God, we have returned to the season of ordinary time. We begin today the second part of the season, continuing from week 8. We had begun with the first part after Christmas, beginning from week 1 to week 7. Then we entered the season of Lent, and the season of Easter followed. The season of Easter having ended yesterday with the Feast of Pentecost, we now return to the second part of the season of ordinary time, beginning from week 8. This second part of ordinary time will run till the 34th week, which is the last week of the church's year. Today's gospel focuses on our desire to enter heaven and the things that stand on our way and that can prevent us from realizing this dream, this desire. We want to enter heaven, dear friends, but there are many things that block us and stand between us and our desire for heaven. This truth is brought to us through the story of the rich young man in today's gospel. Saint Basil the Great, commenting on this text, says the young man was aged between 24 and 40. Wow! Just in his 20s or 30s, he had made it in life to be extremely rich at his age. In fact, looking at the account of Saint Luke, Saint Luke does not only say he was rich or was young, he says he was a ruler. Perhaps he had inherited the wealth, or perhaps being a ruler that made him exceedingly rich. The point is, he was rich though a young person. We should think nothing should trouble him anymore, right? He's a rich young man. All his problems should be over. There are many his age, even above his age, still struggling to make ends meet. And here he is, a young man who is exceedingly rich. Yet, despite all his riches, this rich young man still felt a void. There was still an emptiness inside of him. This shows that money isn't everything, beloved. Money isn't everything. This is a rich young man who was still in want. If he did not lack anything, he would not have met Jesus. But to show the void that was inside of him, despite his money and wealth, he ran to Jesus. He did not need money, but he needed happiness. That kind of happiness that money cannot buy or cannot give. That is why he approached Jesus. Good master, what must I do to inherit eternal life? Listen to his question. What must I do to inherit eternal life? It was a question that supposed that he had realized that all his money meant nothing. What is wealth without eternal life? What is wealth without happiness? Some think that money gives them happiness, but here is a man who had all the money, yet he was not happy, and that is why he rushed to Jesus. What must I do to inherit eternal life? He needed true and lasting happiness, and only eternal life could give him. Not his money, not his wealth, not even his position. Jesus told him, to have eternal life, to have this happiness that you are looking for, avoid evil. Keep the commandments. These things he had done from when he was just a boy. One thing is left, Jesus added. You have kept the commandments, fine and good. Now, one thing, go and sell what you own and give the money to the poor. Beloved, the selling Jesus is talking about here must not necessarily mean a literal selling, like going to the market to trade his goods. The selling Jesus is talking about here is in a figurative language. It is detachment. Cut off. Disassociate yourself from these material things you have. But this he would not do. His face fell. His riches stood between him and his desire for heaven. He wanted to be happy. He wanted eternal life. But he would not get it. Not because he was denied. He denied himself. His riches stood between him and his heaven. He wanted heaven, but was not ready to do what would obtain the heaven for him. Dear friends, by analogy, if you are hungry and you have money, you should be ready to spend the money to buy food for yourself. But if you are hungry and you have money and you're not ready to spend the money, then you won't have the food. You must let go of something in order to gain another thing. But this is what the rich young man would not do. He wants happiness, but he's not ready to trade those things that prevent him from getting happiness. Because of his riches, he missed heaven. This is the problem with riches. Not that they are bad in and in themselves, no. But they have the potential of blocking us from reaching heaven. Do you know why? It is because we get too attached to them and it becomes difficult to separate ourselves from them. We get too glued to our riches that we begin to adore them. Riches have a way of pulling our hearts away from God. Rather than serving and worshiping God, we rather serve the things that God has given us. Riches make us foolish. We now understand the reason for the parable of the rich fool. Compare Luke chapter 12, verses 16 to 21. He was rich, but described as a rich fool, because in his riches, he lacked wisdom. Confess Psalm 49, verse 20. This young man represents every one of us. Like him, we all desire heaven. We all want to enter heaven. Deep in every one of us, dear friends, there is a quest for heaven. But many things and persons stand on our way that block us. For him, it was his riches, his material wealth. We also have our own riches that block us. For some of us, like the rich young man, it could be our own material wealth that stand between us and our heaven. Dear friend, if you want to make heaven, detach from those riches. Your riches that block you from heaven could be that particular sin or sins that you keep committing and never seem to quit or stop from them. You realize that if you were to go to confession every day, you would confess this particular or particular sins every day. That is what stands between you and your heaven. Your riches could be that bad company you keep. There are some friends we have. They are bad company. But we find it difficult cutting away from them. And I tell you, they are your riches. They stand between you and your heaven. That is the one thing you need to do in order to enter heaven. Detach from them. Sell them in order to enter heaven. But if you trust that friendship and treasure that friendship much more than your heaven, then you've got to forgo one for another. In the language of economics, it is a matter of choice. And when you make a choice, there is a foregone alternative. So choose between keeping your bad company or your heaven. It is an invitation for us today, therefore, to detach from that one thing that stands between you and your heaven. It could be a thing, or it could be a person or persons. Each one of us knows what exactly will take us to hell. We know. We are good in every other thing except that one thing that is our soft spot and that will lead us to hell. Dear friend, fight it. Identify that one thing and detach from it. It could be lies telling. You are so good, so generous, so kind, so loving, but oh, lies, lies, lies telling will be what will take you to hell. Go sell it so that you can make heaven. It could be cheating in business or in your transactions with people. Dear friend, go sell it so that you can make heaven. It could be anger. Oh, anger. You are so nice, so friendly, so welcoming. But anger will take you to hell. Dear friend, go sell it. That is the riches you have. Go sell it that you can make heaven. It could be sexual immorality or promiscuity. Dear friend, go sell it. Go sell it. Detach from it so that you can make heaven. It could be gossip. Oh, you are a wonderful person. But gossip will not let you be. You talk even about things you do not know. Dear friend, that is your riches. Go sell it. Go sell it. Detach from it so that you can make heaven. It could be theft. It could be drunkenness or whatever. Dear friend, identify that one thing. Identify those riches that stand between you and your heaven. Go sell them that you can make heaven. Detach from them that you can gain heaven. Let us pray today through the intercession of Our Lady, help of Christians, that each and every one of us may fight for our salvation with fear and trembling to look for those things that will take us to heaven. We wish each and every one of you a very blessed new week and a new season of ordinary time. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.